Hey everybody, welcome back. It's great to have you here. Now, if I mention the name of my guests, the band you're about to meet, they need no introduction. I mean, it's impossible, really, really impossible to meet anyone who'll say, I don't know who they are. Many have cried and fallen in love and even have gotten empowered by their beautiful lyrics. Long story short, they're so good, they were named twice. We're gonna chit-chat with Ben and Ben. Come on. First of all, thank you, twins, for being here. And I have to ask you, as a twin, some twin questions.
Okay.
No, like, I'm sure you fight. Do you fight?
Yes, we do.
That
yes,
means yes. That high note, that high note was a yes.
Yeah, definitely. It's part of our life.
Nahirapan ba kayo? But like, kunyari, it's work mode, it's time to create, and then someone disagrees. How do you solve the problem so that you can go on with your magic?
To be honest po, we've gotten a lot better with it over time. Pero dati, I think most of the drama happened before we became like a band. Yeah. Tsaka no early days. I would say we're quite passive aggressive. Like you can feel my silence. Mas ganon. Rather than parang upfront na. And eventually we'd talk about it and then of course it would be tense, ganyan. Pero usually kami parang
usually okay lang ba tayo?
Okay lang.
In harmony pa, sabay-sabay.
Pero alam mo hindi. And then when, for example, you know, writing a song, of course when you're starting to do it, you have an idea,
right?
And then you have so much attachment to that idea you contributed that you feel like if it gets shut down, parang ay,
it's a personal attack.
Oh. And then eventually we learned na, songs are of their own entity.
Right.
So when it's a song, you throw in ideas and then if they don't get used, it's fine. Parang, but yep. It takes a while to learn that.
So nobody gets pecked to the point where we're not doing that song. It's not gonna work.
You're not agreeing with me.
But who is, I don't know if this is a fair question to ask, but who is correct or who is right most of the time?
50-50.
Oh.
Nice answer.
But eventually, you learn na no one's right, but yung, mahirap siya explain eh. Parang yung idea yung tama. Parang hindi siya yung dahil idea mo siya or idea ko siya. It's just the idea that is right and that will win. But
okay,
at first, you feel like, okay, sige, ako yung tama, ako yung mali, ganyan. But then when you detach yourself from it and then you make it about the song, you know na, oh, this is the best for the song.
Right. Let's go to your music. Where did it all start? Where did it come from? Who knew before the other? Or did you both find out that you had equal love for the music, for this craft that you now have mastered and do so well? When did it all start?
I think it started as early as when we were 5 years old. But not playing yet. It's more of our mom would play classics and your music and worship music also. So I think that subconsciously ingrained in us our love for music. And eventually when we were in high school, we started a band with our batchmates and we also didn't sing yet. So I think for us, playing guitar and for me, writing songs came before we learned how to sing.
No, we didn't sing at all. Like we didn't have the confidence to
sing. Was guitar the first instrument you played? Back then, when you were kids, it's always been the guitar.
Mm, yeah, and eventually piano.
Yeah, but the funny story with that is, so we learned guitar almost at the same time. And then, of course, you would understand that growing up, when you have a twin, laging may comparison, di ba? And then you tend to compare yourself too. So I was like, oh, ang galing niya bigla sa gitara. Tapos parang hindi siya masyado nagpa-practice. Tapos ako, practice, di ako gumagaling. So, and that's how I learned how to play the piano, because I was like, I have to have my own.
I'm gonna try something else, right?
Yeah, and then he kept getting better at guitar, so I was like, I have to have another thing. So I started writing songs for the band. That's how it started.
What were your musical influences?
Well, our whole lives we shared a room, and then we, in our first home, we lived in an attic. Na ganun yung bubong, and then we'd play all these like Beatles records until we'd fall asleep.
Wow.
Eventually we'd explore all of this catalog of old music, and we'd be like really fascinated by how people used to write songs, because they had so much like depth and emotion, and the melodies were beautiful. Ayun. And then we were talking about Mr. C earlier, right? In 2013, we had the opportunity to join this music camp. It's called Elements.
Yes.
A lot of yung generation namin ng musicians started
sila,
from
Moira,
yeah. We all started from that camp. Most of us, and then you know, na open yung doors of like how beautiful Filipino songwriting is.
Is there a certain formula to writing a great song?
Actually, I think the more time we create music, and we also observe like how music is created, we realize na parang wala. Kasi, well, we also hear that all the time, and we try to embody that too, yung right from the heart. Because it could really go anywhere, and it could work, it could not work, but that level of personal connection and authenticity is the only thing that you actually have under your thumb, and then everything else is, it just comes. And then sometimes you have a good hand, meaning you have like the good elements that would make something connect to people, but sometimes you don't, and that's okay.
When was that eureka moment that, aha, let's make it a 9-piece band?
Yeah.
When did the Benjamins feel that we needed to be 9-piece? And why 9? Why not 10? Why not 5? Why not 15?
Maganda, no man. Bakit nga 9?
Naisip kayo na, wow!
It's really the music that that led us to where we are. Because when we were starting out, we met our future bandmates sa iba-ibang mga places. And then, when we recorded our songs, that's when we wanted to bring them in the studio. And then when it all came together, because we really didn't have an idea of how we're gonna play it live.
And we also didn't have a plan.
And we didn't have a plan, actually. Because we just graduated after. And then, and shortly after, that's when we tried it. And then we were like, okay, I guess let's try it once. So when we launched that EP with 6 songs, which included Leaves, Katangisim, and Ride Home, and three other songs, that's when we got everyone together to play for the first, and we thought like the last time, because of course, being respectful of the craft, we wanted to be able to compensate everyone, and really make it an experience that's memorable for everyone. But we knew that it wouldn't be easy to pull that off like for a long time, so we just thought, okay, one night only, ganyan. Coming home to you.
Now, I know the one thing I respect more than anything else about Ben and Ben is your love and respect for all 9 of you. I remember the first time we tried to get you, we said, it's not just 2 of us. Ben and Ben is not 2. It's all 9 of us. I wish I could have all 9 with us here today, but we will have a couple more to join us on stage to tell us more about the journey that is Ben and Ben. We'll be right back. What was some of the first songs that you played with your guitar? Do you remember?
I would say Yesterday by the Beatles.
Yesterday, Love was such an easy game to play. Now I need a place to hide away. Oh, I believe in yesterday.
Nice. Any further than that, we have to pay, right?
Gets natin yan.
I know you get that. I know you get it.